encourage you to make positive career choices, but we also want to develop young entrepreneurs. You know, because the most important thing you can be as an entrepreneur is a business owner. We need more minority business owners. Anybody know why? Anybody know why? May y'all must be still dragging from last night. Huh? Because you know what? It creates jobs. So the gentleman I'm going to introduce to you, he's had an opportunity to start his own business, and he'll tell you how many people he employs. And, you know, when you start looking at, you know, minorities, you really have to think, you know, there was a time when John, Deacon and I, we couldn't get a job. People wouldn't hire people of color. They only started hiring people of color when they absolutely had to. The government passed a thing called affirmative action that meant that so many percent of your employees had to be minorities. Minorities didn't just constitute blacks. It constituted foreigners who came to the country, and women were all considered a minority. And so that was their way of not having to hire more black. So what we did, we had more people jump up and start, well, you know what, I'll start my own business. I hire these people. So that people like myself, you know, and John and Deacon Everett could have a job. So this time, I'd like to introduce to you the owner of the GSFEK, that's the Old Roller K, and he's also president of the Minority Business Association, and I will let him introduce it. I drew a blank on what I was saying. This time, just give a hand to Deacon Gregory Everett.
Thank you very much. Good okay. to see one of my
yes, sir.
John.
Yes, sir.
Also, a gentleman yes, that we thank God first and foremost for Mr. Tony Burns, the director. I'd like to say, first and foremost, that God is truly on the throne. He's the man that got me to where I'm at today. I am a deacon in the church at St. Luke Baptist Church. We're now without a pastor, but God willing, we will be having a pastor soon. At this time, I'd just like to say to what Director Grimes was just saying, I'm going to ask all you kids to kind of give me a name, and I'm going to try to go through a professional setup on what they do when they get ready to try to interview you for a job, but also give you a history and a background. Although, like you said, you drew a blank, I am the president and founder and CEO of the first African Black Chamber of Commerce. Now, most of you probably don't know what Chambers of Commerce is all, but I'm going to try to get into that and try to bring you up to where you need to be and to understand entrepreneurship. But before I do and go any further, I want to just give credit to this gentleman right here and Mr. Ryan for something that they did back then with the East Akron YMCA. This young man right here is my nephew, and he's now called Little Stewie. And y'all might know him, might have went to school, may have played basketball or whatever with him. And he's an excellent basketball player. He's also great in school and getting grades. And John and I and Mr. Grimes, we helped put this program. They helped put this program together at our venue. Now, look at this e-bio, raise your hand. Did anybody attend this here at this program? Did any of you guys come here? Anybody?
YMCA?
Well, not just to the YMCA, when they had for the police officers and a day that was down there at the Y when this young rapper was down there. It was very positive because no one attended, right? No one here? Oh, you fit? Okay, so you knew about it. You seen the facility, and you also... Your granddad? Great. And that's what we need. We need more father figures. We need more grandfathers to get with their kids, grandchildren, to come out and be more than just role models, but to be leaders in their role models, to show the kids what they need to do. I'd like to just start off, like I said, I would have liked to have gotten some of you guys' names, but maybe also a sticker, but that's all right. I'm going to ask, just going around and starting on this side, young man with the cup. What is your name?
Larry.
Larry, what?
Larry Christmas.
All right. Young man back there, what's your name?
Easy.
Easy?
Yeah.
What's your last
Easy
name?
Moss.
Easy Moss? Okay, I'm going to have everybody speak up. This young man here, what's your name?
Lamar Jones.
Lamar Jones?
Yeah.
Okay, what about you, man?
My name is
Leon,
King.
King? Okay. Speak up, I can't hear you.
John
Owens. Owens? What about you, Leon?
John.
What is it?
John
Rivers?
Riggins.
Riggins.
Thank you,
Buckley. What is it?
Andre.
Smolder?
Moser.
I know a lot of parents.
Trey Becker.
What?
Trey Becker.
Becker? Okay. Young man in orange?
Elijah Harris.
Is he young?
Kevin Smith.
Smith?
Yes, Moss.
Moss? Okay. What about you?
Jamarcus.
Stubbs?
Yes.
Okay. And one instructor, I guess, that is.
Timothy Holtz.
It's a pleasure to have y'all do that because a lot of times what Mr. Grimes was just talking about was very hard back in the days when we were coming up. You know, a lot of times you might look at me and probably think I'm in my 30s or 40s, but I'm a much older man than that. And on top of that, I'm 55 years old. Just turned 55, April 20th. And I thank God for being here today because of all the things that I've suffered. I just come out of the hospital just to let you know why I got a little bit of madness in my system and just had major surgery on this elbow. And it wasn't anything due to my place of business to where I got injured. But God be willing now, I just want to let you know that it's been a rough time with all the things that I have suffered here in the past month. Yes, sir.
So you own an arcade place?
It's not just an arcade place, and I'm glad you asked that question. You probably would have heard why we did not want to put all these games in there, because money is good to have, but you know, they say all money isn't good money. And you'll get some people that might want to say they want to debate that. And the reason why we didn't want to put arcades or those kind of games into our skating facility, because mostly all you young men right now, pretty much just by a show of hands, who when they get back home will go play either Sega, Atari, which that's old school,
right,
PlayStation, or some game? Just raise your hand. Who's going to be playing a game? Come on. Y'all got these games, I know. Come on.
Mine's broken.
Yours broken. Well, okay, we got at least maybe 25-30%.
I got them, but I don't.
You don't need them? Okay, well, let me tell you, that's a good thing because you don't need to really be spending a lot of time playing games. When we were coming up, there was a game called, first game that ever came out was called Atari. We played that game. Y'all might have seen it, but we did not play games all the time. Our activities has been here. I came here when I was I don't know if he's the youngest one. But we came here when we were kids, 4, 5, 6 years old, to the same camp. Sawmill Creek, Pigeon Creek, and all these different creeks that we had to name and know, even in Boy Scouts. And I made it all the way up to the Eagle Scouts. That's a little bit later on down the road. But going back to the initial question, I want to get to you about those games. We did not want to be down here, but for some reason, it seemed to me that God led people like Mr. Grimes, John, and he was opening up in Cleveland. I'm sure he has that same background, to where we came to facilities like this and learned about nature, learned about a lot of things. And our scoutmasters, instructors like these young, great black men here, taught us how to survive, how to start a fire, how to do all the things. I know you're here under an entrepreneur class today. But I want to share these things. These are some of the things that we did to get to where this gentleman and myself is at right now today. Yes, sir.
You learned how to make a fire, like without before, like matches and stuff.
Yes,
like
sir. Yes, we learned to do all of that. In Boy Scouts, in camps. I mean, those were the things to know. Those things taught us how to deal with if you didn't have these things and people that were without. There were still people when we were your sizes and ages, kids that were in houses that were cold. We still had potbelly stoves. Y'all probably don't know nothing about that. Those were changes of times to where y'all got all the luxuries and comforts right now of gas.
Being like that,
and
being like this, I care about y'all. I'm telling you, I know. See, it was God's plan for this to take place today. And that's what's going to keep you here. But y'all gotta know what you gotta have. I think you won't like that. I know that young man over here. He's trying.
I'm gonna try to do everything I can. Anything that I can. Paperwork means a lot. I don't know what you really want to do. Football player, jazz musician, rap, whatever the case may be. But I'm gonna need to find out. Because I'm gonna try to help with
this man's group. I said it when he asked me about coming on board, and I became like a daisy. I never got out of it. I just got so caught up. My mother-in-law passed. Prior to that, before my mother-in-law passed, my uncle died. One day before my mother-in-law